Karen has been sharing her music around New Jersey and beyond since 2011, when she wrote her first song at the age of 54, just a youngin' at that time. Her music has been played on WNTI, WFDU, WMSC, WIMG, and Sirius XM Radio, and the Folk Project Television. Songs from her three CDs and information about her first cozy mystery novel, which features five original songs, can be found at her website, which is KarenKamenetsky.com.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are extremely pleased to welcome for the very first time ever here to Cafe Improv, Karen Kamenetsky.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. I was actually scheduled to play here on April 25th of 2020. That didn't go so well. So I'm really happy to be here today. And it is Earth Day today, so I thought I'd play a couple of my songs that are on that theme. This first one was inspired by a story in the Talmud about a young man walking along a road, and he saw an old man planting a tree. And he said to the old man, "How long is it going to take that tree to grow and bear fruit?" It was a carob tree. And the old man said, "It's going to take about 40 years. And the young man said, "I believe in 40 years you'll be dead." And the old man said, "I'm not planting this tree for me. I'm planting it for my children and my grandchildren. This is Grandpa's tree."
Home from school one day, and I found my grandpa in the yard. Had his shovel in his hand, and he was working hard. Dirt was flying, he was smiling. Said, "I think I have one thing to say. If you want your grandchildren to sit in the shade, you gotta plant that tree today." And I said, "Grandpa, you'll be long gone before that tree is grown." I said, "Grandpa, I'll be sitting in the shade alone." And I said, "Grandpa, seems like a crazy thing to do." He said, "My grandpa planted a tree for me, and I'm planting this one for you." He said, "My grandpa planted a tree for me, and I'm planting this one for you." He took that seedling from its burlap sack, placed it gently in the ground. He said, "Son, you know I won't always be around." The sun was shining, he was smiling. He said, "I think that you will find there are some things that we do not for ourselves, but for the ones that we leave behind." And I said, "Grandpa, you'll be long gone before that tree is grown." I said, "Grandpa, I'll be sitting in the shade alone." Said, "Grandpa, seems like a crazy thing to do." He said, "My grandpa planted a tree for me, and I'm planting this one for you." He said, "My grandpa planted a tree for me, and I'm planting this one for you." Grown into a tall and sturdy tree. I sit beneath it with my granddaughter on my knee. Well, the sun is shining, I see her smiling. I tell her just what he would say. You want your grandchildren to sit in the shade, you gotta plant that tree today. She says, "Grandpa, you'll be long gone before that tree is grown." she says, Grandpa, seems like a crazy thing to do. I say, my grandpa planted a tree for me, and I'm planting this one for you. I say, my grandpa planted a tree for me, and I'm planting this one for you.
Thank you very much. So, having a little drink. It's just water. With lemon. I'm a huge fan of the Jersey tomato. Huge fan. And I like them only in the summer, and they have to be local. So I wrote a song about it. Which, interestingly enough, is the only one of my songs that I know of that's been covered on YouTube by a gentleman named Marco from the Morristown Uke Federation. He did a ukulele tutorial with this song. It's pretty simple, really easy chords, and the chorus is pretty easy, and once I go around, you'll probably be able to get the hang of it, and I'd love to have you join in. And even, if you can do some harmony, that'd be fabulous. It's called My Tomato. My tomato doesn't have a first name, so I decided to call him Tom. I saw him sitting in the grocery store. I said, Tom, where are you from? He said, it's January. Did you think I grew outside in New Jersey? I was doing just fine in California till they ripped me from the vine too early. We have a problem. I want my tomatoes to come from New Jersey. I want them to ripen on the vine. Wanna get them at the farm stand the day they bring the harvest in. I don't wanna eat any other kind. Your part next time it comes around. And Tom said, I spent the last 5 days in the back of a truck with a flat of strawberries and a case of romaine. Also, you could pretend that the seasons don't exist, which, by the way, I think is insane. He said, it's January, why don't you eat a rutabaga or a red potato? I was bred to store and ship, so I'm merely pale and tasteless. I'm no Ramapo. Here comes the part. I said, Tom, I have to agree because I want my tomatoes to come from New Jersey. I want them to ripen on the vine. Farm stand the day they bring the harvest in. I don't want to eat any other kind. Get one more time to try that. And Tom said, you knew this day was coming and you could have been prepared. It's not that hard to do. There are many ways to preserve a tomato, canning and freezing and drying, just to name a few. And then in January, you can take a jar down off the shelf and break the seal. Pull some roasted Romas out of the freezer. Have sun-dried tomatoes at every meal. Here it comes. Said Tom, that's what I'm talking about, 'cause I want my tomatoes to, come from New Jersey. All right. I want them to ripen on the vine. I want to get them at the farm stand the day they bring the harvest in. I don't want to eat any other kind. One more time.
other kind. One more time. Any other kind.
Very nice. You did a good job. Another drink. Okay, so I've been told about writing songs that even if you're writing a song about something really personal, you should try to expand the theme so it will appeal to as many people as possible, not just all about you, all about you, all about you, which might be good advice. I'm not sure because Taylor Swift. But anyway, I didn't pay any attention to that advice when I wrote this song, which I wrote very recently. It's about me. It's about something that bothers me. And I figure statistically, there might be a half a person in the room who has the same problem. But I wrote it anyway. And I'm going to play it anyway. I was born in 57. At the end of the boom, named after my grandmother, a good woman who died too soon. I share the name my mother gave me with 40,000 other little girls born that same year. Then one person's bad behavior made the truth of who I am just disappear. I am a boomer, and there's gonna be a song about that soon. My name is Karen. There's something I'd like to see change if it's all the same to you. Stop taking my name in. Stop taking my name. Stop taking my name in vain. Yeah, stop taking my name. I've seen the clips on YouTube. The 6 o'clock news. That screaming racist woman. I have heard the hate she spews. Well, she does not represent me or all the other Karens I have known. Good to their core. I don't know how they all feel, but I am done. This doesn't work for me anymore. I am a boomer. My name is Karen. There's something I'd like to see change if it's all the same. You stop taking my. Stop taking my name. Stop taking my name in vain. Yeah. Stop taking my name. I know you'll say get over it. I can't. Tell me to just let go of it. I won't. Another name for the reprehensible seems to me blatantly sensible. Something that fits the profile to a T. May I suggest Lauren or Marjorie? My name, I am a boomer. My name is Karen. There's something I'd like to see change. It's all the same to you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. See, I have a point, right? I mean, if it was your name, you wouldn't like it. Right. So, okay, so this last song. Oh, so I'll just mention, because it's Earth Day, I brought you a present out there in the lobby on that table, a whole bunch of CDs. It's my first CD, and I have a million of them, because they tell you to buy a lot, and it's a bunch of bunk. But anyway, it's got the tomato song on it, so you should take it home. Just take it home. It's yours. It's a gift. It's free. I'm sorry? No, the Karen song I just wrote a couple weeks ago. It's not recorded. So you should take it home, and you know, you can learn how to play it, because it's pretty easy. It's just like a G progression or something. So this song, it's called Fight Like a Hero. Sometimes I write songs about things that are happening that I feel passionately about, and I write them from my perspective. Might not be your perspective. It's okay, we don't have to agree. We could have a civil conversation, which is a reference to another one of my songs, which is on my website. Go look. We could have a civil conversation and talk about it. Oh, and you know what else? I have tote bags with the chorus to the tomato song on it. See me later. Okay, this song is called Fight Like a Hero. These seem like times the likes of which we've never seen before, but that's just because we forget so easily. Rich white old men want to run our bodies and our lives. If you think that's news, you better read some history. You can read about Sarah Weddington, Alice Paul, Sojourner Truth, Dr. King, about Cesar Chavez, Michael Schwerner, Aisha Evans, Heather Heyer. Here's the thing, they did not sit by and hope a hero would come along to save the day. They stood up, stepped into the fray. You believe in something, you got to fight like a hero every day. Woman's right to choose, black man's right not to be shot on sight, every person's right to live their own sexuality. There are some things feel worth fighting for to me, in a country where we claim that we are free. And you got to fight like Sarah Weddington. Paul, Sojourner Truth, Dr. King, like Cesar Chavez, Andrew Goodman, Aisha Evans, Heather Heyer. Change is gonna be a thing. You cannot sit by and hope a hero will come along to save the day. You've got to stand up, step into the fray. Fight like a hero every day. Change doesn't happen without heroes who stand up to lead the way. Any one of us could be a hero. Like Cesar Chavez and James Chaney, Aisha Evans, Heather Heyer. Change is gonna be a thing. You cannot sit by and hope.
Fight like a hero every day. You got to fight like a hero.
Thank you very much. It's been a pleasure playing for you.
Karen Kamenetsky. Thank you. You do have time for one more if you wanted one. Not gonna push it. Not gonna push it.
I could try.
Okay, so I probably have to write a new version of this because I wrote it when I was 54, and I'm a lot older than that now. So
I woke up this morning and I'm older than I'm older than I ever thought I'd be. I looked in the mirror. I said, is this even possible? I'm looking back at half a century. And I've got bags and I've got sags and I've got wrinkles where they didn't used to be. And I'm not the woman I was when I was 17. And I know some things today that I wish I had known back then, like nobody has perfect hair. You're more than the clothes you wear. And they airbrush all those photos in the magazine.
I think I have a new fan.
I woke up this morning. Older than I thought I was. I'm older than I ever thought I'd be. I looked in the mirror. I said, are you even kidding me? I look like I've been alive for half a century. I've got bags and I've got shags and I've got wrinkles where they did it used to be. And now woman I was when I was 29. And I know some things today that I wish I had known back then, like men are from another planet, it's true. They don't want to talk about their feelings with you. And we can't live without them, but they can't live without us more. I woke up this morning and I'm older than I ever thought I'd be. I looked in the mirror. I said, are you even kidding me? I look like I've been alive for half a century. And I've got bags and I've got shags and I've got wrinkles where they didn't used to be. And I'm not the woman I was when I was 39. That first gray hair, you can refuse to act your age if you dare, cause you're as old, only as old as you feel in your heart and your mind.
I haven't played this one in a while. Yeah.
I woke up this morning and I'm older than I was 45. And I know some things today that I fingers like sand. And you should do one thing that you love every day you're alive. I'm gonna do one thing that I love every day I'm alive. Yeah, I'm gonna do one thing that I love every day I'm alive. Thank you very much.
Karen Kamenetsky, thank you. Once again, she has brought us gifts. She has brought us gifts. CDs in the back, yes. Thank you so much, Karen Kamenetsky. I'm going to hand the mic over.
All righty. Well, Dave Bolger, come on down here. We'll talk about you. A New Jersey-based singer-songwriter and poet who's been performing for over 5 decades. Dave's music features his own compositions, as well as interpretations of songs in a variety of genres, old and new. He performs with the Cicada Brothers throughout New Jersey, and in the 1980s, Dave was a member of the New York City-based Fast Folk Musical organization, and a recording of his original song, Sidewalks of New York, was featured in their magazine.
Ladies and gentlemen, this gentleman was here over and over again. He was one of our favorite artists from about, more than the last month ago. And so we are so pleased to welcome back to Cafe Improv for the second, fourth, or 23rd time ever here to Cafe Improv, Dave Bolger.
Thank you. Thank you. It's going to be tough because my daughter, Sarah, who performed earlier, played all the stuff that I was going to play. So I don't know what I'm going to do. But seriously, it's really great to be back here at Cafe Improv with all you good people. It really, really feels really good. So thank you. Thank you for the opportunity. I'm going to do some original songs tonight, and I'm going to do a poem. I'd like to open with a song called Winter Blues. It's one of my own compositions, and it's not a song about having winter blues. It's about what happens after it passes, when the beautiful weather like we've been having lately finally comes. That's what this song is kind of about. In the deep and fevered sleep of this old town, where the cold is moving on and rolls unbound, every day is a falling out, and that is no lie. We design the soul of winter light, line by line. Chilly one, come go with me as we turn out, but kind of slow like we used to know when we first came round. Every day was a falling out, and that is no lie. We designed the soul of winter light, line by line. Every day dreams tumble down, close your eyes and pick one out, they're all the same. Every day dreams tumble down, close your eyes and pick one out, they're all the same. Snows come round, turn aside and rub your eyes and roll on out. Every day is a falling out, and that is no lie. We design the soul of winter light, line by line. Every day dreams tumble down,
Close your eyes and pick one out, they're all the same. Every day dreams tumble down. Close your eyes and pick one out, they're all the same.
Thank you. Thanks very much. This next song is called Night of Brightness. It's a tune that I wrote for an album that I produced back in the 90s. It was the first song on the album, and so I consider it a kind of an evocation of the muse.
There's a finite tune on the radio whisper. Just an ordinary night, a night full of brightness falling. I've been wondering all about you. I seldom see the sight on a long, cool ribbon of a rolling road. I seldom see the sight of her mild face. I remember I was driving all day long from hell to my delight. I was driving all day long from hell to my delight. She blooms in grace from a troubled sleep with form before her mind. She blooms in grace from a troubled sleep with form before her mind. Once in a mile you'll see the roadway turn up towards the sky. There's a fine high tune on the radio whisper. Just an ordinary night, a night full of brightness falling. I was driving all day long from hell to my delight. I was driving all day long from hell to my delight. She blooms in grace from a troubled sleep with form before her mind. She blooms in grace from a troubled sleep with form before her mind.
Thanks very much. And now to change things up a little, I'd like to read a poem. The reason I chose to read it was because I wrote it while biking on the DNR Canal towpath, which is not very far from here. I was kind of pedaling along and coming up with this song. I read it at a celebration of my 70th birthday. And so the title of the there's a lot of you that passed me pretty far, you know. It's called Thoughts on My 70th Year. One morning, as I strolled downtown beneath a bright blizzard of winter sunlight, a solemn acquaintance took my arm and hauled me into one of those conspiratorial sidewalk conversations that I could not seem to pull myself away from. He spoke concerning our arrival at the autumn of life, which is true enough, I suppose, but if I must consider my friend's tired likening of old age to golden oak trees, I thought to myself that life is much too absurdly short to encompass even one miserly season, let alone a year's worth. So I say, our lives begin and end in the span of a single season, and we live out our entire lives, strivings, in a rainy and inexpressible springtime. After all, the moment of birth and winter's end are both wet and agonizingly slow. We sense the warming breaths of March in disbelief and sprout into a grumbling lifespan of yearning that we refuse to ever surrender. We shove forward and arrive at our last pirate breath in the June heat, overgrown with weedy and overripe ambitions. Of course, if the good die young, then we who stumble on to 70 and beyond may be wise to reconsider our vaunted virtues before the cool green summer of our crazy sleep. Thank you. I'd like to finish with a song that I wrote for my band, the Cicada Brothers, that couldn't be here tonight. It's called, hold on. Bird's nest in my mailbox, robot on my phone. Exercise music everywhere I go, everywhere I roam. So I called up this lady, wished the best on me. Told her I was sinking in the waves of the endless sea. And this is what she said to me. Life is rough, baby, tough, baby. So if you'd be so bold as to rock me off my feet, baby, rock my soul, it's the best, baby, the best, honey. If you'll come on down, won't you get up off your feet, baby? Ooh, rock it around. Could not find my walking shoes, could not find my hat, wallet full of wanted. I hate to go out like that. I hate to go out like that. So tip tap on my window, rattle on my wall, shake my soul with heart, baby. Don't you hear my call? Won't you take my call? Life is rough, baby, tough, baby. So if you'd be so bold as to rock me off my feet, baby, rock my soul, it's the best, baby, the best, honey. If you'll come on down, won't you get up off your feet, baby? Ooh, rock it round. Life is rough, baby, tough, baby. So if you be so bold as to rock me off my feet, baby, rock my soul, it's the best, baby, the best, honey. If you come on down, won't you get up off your feet, baby? Ooh, rock it round. Thank you very much.
Dave, who's in the Cicada Brothers nowadays?
Consisting of Harris Goodman and Al Rabaska, and we've been playing all over New Jersey for years.
Wow, that's great. Harris played here, I'm going to say, before you did.
Yes, he did. Iris is still.
Oh, he's great.
Still going.
Oh, thank you so much. Dave Bolger, thank you so much. I mean, wait there. I'm going to unplug you. You are tethered. Thank you so much, Dave.
Brian St. John, come on down, because Brian is a singer, songwriter, and multi-instrumentalist from Sussex County, New Jersey. So he has played up and down the East Coast, including local venues like the Stone Pony and Maxwells and the Newton Theater, after putting out 3 albums with his eponymous quartet. He's released four live records and 5 studio records, including his latest, Dirty Tetris, on streaming services, CDs, and a limited edition red vinyl. Vinyl, I guess, is making a comeback here, limited edition.
Ladies and gentlemen, you know, I'm going to say he's one of the really great performers in New Jersey these days. Brian St. John, thank you so much.
Brings back every word, you know, our patience tells us. ages, but our love remains the same.
My name's Brian. It's a pleasure to be here. We were trying to figure it out. It's either like the seventh or eighth time, something like that. Is it 10? But thanks for having me, as per usual. And ladies and gentlemen, this is Mr. John Irizarry playing the keys for you. He's from Morris County. I hope that's okay. Passports accepted from the great north. All right, this one's called The Moon Will Burn Brighter, My Darling. Wish I was alive in those beautiful nights. Think I'm tired of rambling. It's all fate coming round a corner. This time I'll be a man. I'll hide the moon inside into my love. Burns bright, my darling. Sometimes I feel understandable. Silence is how I find my way. Love seems to be intangible. I'll hide the moon inside into my
since that consumed my love. Burns bright, my darling.
Thank you. I'm not typically one for the autobiographical. But this one's called Stubborn Man. And I'll let you decide. Thank you.
You got way too long. You got the nerve to stay strong. I'll take your time, I'll do what you can. I'm working on me, but I am what I am. I'm a stubborn man. Well, I'm a stubborn man. With my love, I'm a stubborn man. Well, I'm a stubborn man.
Thank you. All right, so I'm going to level with you. I don't know the words to any of my own songs. Doesn't mean they're not good. This one I co-wrote with my good friend John. It's about people on the internet. Yeah. It's called Influencers. You're giving all you can. Take another on the chin. Wasted away like castles in the sand. It's just the shape you're in. A shot thrown in the dark. Filters casting light makes the landscape brighter every day. The void just stalks your sight. When you get one wrong, you lose desire. For we all make it long through the fire. Traps is in. Vindication's there just if you choose. But you're not quite there yet. But when you get one wrong, you lose desire. But we all make it long through the fire. Thank you. Thank you. If you're a guitar person and you're concerned about the guitars, don't worry about it. The good ones stay home. If you like what you hear, all these tunes are from the new record called Dirty Tetris. And thank you. Came out a couple weeks ago, and I did, yeah. So we got them. You can stream it if you want. If you hate artists, you can do that. I'm just kidding. You consume how you wish to consume, but you can stream it. I have CDs, and I do have the limited edition red vinyl. Actual vinyl, which, let me tell you, is a dumb thing to do. It is really expensive. I wouldn't recommend it, but they're not expensive for you. We got, like, T-shirts and sweatshirts and cool stuff, too, so if that's something that you're into. He's got merch. And the less he has to bring back to Sussex County, the better. So, just kidding. Just, what? Umbrella? No.
That's a new one. We need umbrella.
That's a new thing. You gotta try that. I wanted to write a funny breakup song, but like in a hip-hop way where there's like smack talk involved, but they don't really do that in rock or pop music so much. There's a few of them, but they're not very good. So I tried to write a good one. Let's hope I succeeded. This is called Lateral Move. Sometimes a man hits a time in his life when he can't be lonely, I'm so lonely anymore. Begin to feel broken, but you ain't got the drive. Oh, there's something else that you can look for. Moments when confidence builds, no shade of witticism's gonna hold me back from flirting with your friends. And once you've been a tap, you've got nothing else to prove.
federal moon. Once you've been attacked, you've got nothing else to prove. Now that you're gone, being alone is it worse than lateral move? Thank you.
Sorry. These are the guitars I bring to bars, and if somebody dumps a beer on them, it's okay.
It has happened.
It has happened. Oh yeah. I'm from Sussex County. You know. All right, well, we tend to do 80s covers here, so if you don't mind, we'll do a cover.
At the hiring time, there's a line on the color board. just the way it is. Some things never change. That's just the way it is.
Dangerous. Is that right? All right, we do one more here. Is that cool? We like danger. I like the Grateful Dead a lot. We'll do a Grateful Dead song.
Really had to move.
odds are back into a cafe improv door. All night it was pouring, low but not a drop on me. Heard your voice calling, all around the sea, around the sea. And you was coming to me, well, me. Well, I had to move, really.
Thank you very much.
It's Cafe Improv. Can we do a half a thing? Can we do a half a thing? Scott, you brought your djembe. Come on down here. Can we do a half a song? Did Maya's here? You can join us on guitar if you want to. Did I see Sarah in the back? It's a song everybody knows and hates. Everybody, oh, this Dave, come on. All right, come on. Everybody, go just bring him down here.
Mary, you got it?
Okay, it's all in C. It's the only thing. It's the only chord in the whole song. And we'll start the beat like this. Come on, you can play, Maya. Come on. Maybe even a little slower. He knows it.
Brother bought a coconut. He bought it for the dime. Sis but had a $100 she paid him. Lime. She put the lime in the coconut, she drank a boda. She put the lime in the coconut, she drank a boda. She put the lime in the coconut, she drank a boda. She put the lime in the coconut, she called her doctor, woke him up, said, Doctor, ain't there nothing I can take? I said, Doctor, you relieve this belly ache? I said, Doctor.
Everything was perfect. Thank you so much. so much. The next Cafe Improv will be May, whatever that thing is in May. May 25th for Memorial Day. Memorial Day weekend. Oh, I'm playing Porch Fest this week, by the way. On Morris Street at 12 o'clock. Oh, and the Iowa Motion Pictures Association invited us. So we're going to go represent. Okay. Thank you so much.